Hello, ladies and gentlemen. How are you? Well, today we are going to learn how to use AgendaWeb. Remember this website I have been showing you for a while, or at least I have mentioned it. This is agendaweb.org, and the main purpose of visiting this website is just to practice grammar, okay? You know that for me, the most important part is communication and is speaking. But we can use AgendaWeb as well, okay? If you want to improve your grammar, now that you know how to speak some things, say some things in English, you have to work on accuracy. So this is it, all right? As soon as you write down, you type agendaweb.org, it will get you to these exercises. As we want to practice the verb conjugation and different tenses, we're going to click not on grammar. We're going to click on verbs. So a new page or a new tab is going to open, and you will see from the verb to be to, you know, all tenses. So as we were studying the conditionals, we're going to start with this. You click on conditionals, a new tab will open, and we're going to start with conditional one. You remember, we had two conditionals, right? One and two. Or in other, I don't know, in other academies or other teachers say zero conditional, one and two. It could be one, two, three, etc., etc. So as you can see on the left side of your screen, there is a little menu where you can choose zero conditional, first conditional, second conditional, third conditional, or mixed conditionals. We're gonna start with zero conditionals. All right, some of the exercises are pretty easy, others are pretty difficult, and other exercises don't even work. So don't get frustrated, just be a little patient, and we'll get to it. Okay, number one, answer the zero conditional. So in this case, there's a new tab. You will see something like this. It looks like publicity, but it's not. It says, what do you do if? Answer the zero conditional questions by choosing the correct form for each one. Just write the correct number in each box. It says, I ask him to speak more slowly. He tells me to shut up. I make an appointment to see the dentist, etc., etc. They are 18. I'm not going to read everything. So it says, what do you do if you get a headache? Probably number 12. It says, I go and lie down. Let's see. 12. I think it's 12. Let's see now. So you just type the number, and you have to be discovering. If you see that the space, that the blank is really small, then of course that you're going to type only the number. If it's, or maybe just the verb, but if it's a long one, then you will have to type the whole sentence. Let's give it a try. Let's try another exercise. It says time clause, present time clause, and now it says zero conditional, like number 8. Oh no, number 4 seems interesting. So it says, all right, let me make it a bit bigger for you if I can. Oh yeah, I can. Complete the zero conditional sentences with the verb in brackets. Use contractions where possible. He turns, I go, they don't have, his, comes, you aren't, I don't know, and we don't do. If you press that button, the light come on. The light, well, let's try, comes on. It's easier to sleep if you aren't. So as you can see, this one is super simple. So the zero is the simplest form of the conditional. All right, now let's go to the first conditional. First conditionals, you see, again, you go to this page, to the main page, because you're gonna have a lot of tabs open, so you close them all. You go to the first conditional, click there, and then you will see first conditional sentences. Click on one. Even if you think that it's super easy, do not underestimate the exercise, because it can be super simple, but maybe you have some little gaps that you need to fill in, okay? So, number one, if we don't protect the elephant, it will become... Correct. You won't pass the course. You will not pass the course if you don't. Because we already use will. We're not going to use will, right? So, let's review. Let's go back to the beginning. This is the main page, and if you want to study all the conjugations and all the tenses, you will go to the verbs. If you want to study something else, you can go to grammar, you can experiment, okay? You can go to vocabulary, or the listening, or the reading, that's okay. But in this case, we will go always to the verbs. Conditional, future, present continuous, and so on. Okay? So I hope I have helped a lot, and I hope you use this website so you can improve your grammar. See you next time.